G'day guys, welcome back to BMTroubleU, the internet's most comprehensive collection of new BMW and mini DIY videos. Today I'm taking apart the rear door trim off an E65 series. It's not too bad this one, but it's not what you'd expect. Normally what I would have expected is for the wood grain trim to come off and for you to find sort of something beneath that, but that's not the way to go. You take that off, you will break it. And I just take out the airbag symbol you can see above my head there. It just pulls right out, and there's a torque screw behind that. And then on the bottom of the door, you've seen me take off a little bit of coloured trim just to cover the screw. And also on the right-hand side, I'm just doing that now, taking off the trim bits. I forget what those smaller screws are. They might be Phillips heads. But yeah. The other trick about this door is that it's got one big middle clip. So normally I would have also expected for the trim behind the door handle to come off or sort of something to be behind that, but no, again, not. I just sort of work my way around the outsides and take off the, using my plastic trim removal tools again, because otherwise you scratch the paint off the door. Just working off the clips on the outsides. Being careful not to bust anything. Trim's kind of tricky like that. You can give it so much, you just have to sort of know when to stop. Otherwise you get too much. Now you can see I'm trying to take off that very middle bit. You can see it's right behind the door handle there. It's a bit tricky, but what I found is just doing this in a tick, we'll get it off easier. I think it was just a bit of anti-clockwise motion. There you go, look at that. Bonanza. Now, the absolute worst thing about... first of all, I took the bottom light out. That's easy enough. Just push that through and unplug it by pulling out the plug. Easy peasy. The worst thing about it is the airbag. The airbag normally is attached to the door, but on this one, it's attached to the door trim. That is rubbish. It makes it 10 times worse. I've taken off the inside Bowden cable for the door handle. This is the plug. Now, if you see one of these plugs, just run for the hills. It is an absolute mongrel. It's got two stages. You have to slide the black part out first and then depress the little leg on it and pull the whole thing out. It took me like half an hour. This is my first one that I've ever had to deal with. They're not all like this, thankfully. Some of the earlier E60s are just regular sort of push-in plugs that you can get out easy enough. This one was unbelievable. If I never see another one of those again, I will be happy. So basically, what I would recommend is instead of undoing that plug, if you're having troubles, to undo the three Torx screws. There's three Torx screws on the door trim. And I'd undo those instead of unplugging it. And I'd just undo the three Torx screws and leave it hanging because it was just a mongrel. Also, you can see in the middle there, in the sort of the middle cable running down that's part of the airbag plug wiring, it's a little red sort of tiny light that goes in the back of the door trim as well. Don't forget that. It's very delicate, that one, so you've got to be careful. All right, so I've got the door trim off. You can see the black plug still inside the door. If it's inside the trim, which is here, inside the trim, you've got to take it out and put it back in the door from memory. Those are the screws you've got to take out if you want to remove the airbag unit. God, that was a hassle. Anyway, yeah, from memory, you've got to take that plug out of the door trim and put it back into the door before you install the door trim. There's a couple of different things in BMW like that, with the actual clip will come with the trim, but you got to take it out of the trim and put it back where it came from before you can put the trim back on. So that's something to watch out for anyway. Putting the light back in the bottom. All right, that's easy enough. And inside Bowden cable, just like normal sort of other door trims, you got to hold the door handle closed like I'm doing there and then reinsert it. It sort of pushes in on a 45 degree angle and then slots down. it's easy enough. You just dick around with it a bit, you get used to it. And yeah, once you've got the wiring all together, chucking it back on. If you ever have to take off anything more than the trim, I've got other removal videos to show you sort of taking off the butane on the or the butyl tape, sorry, from the inner door seal. That's, extra if you're doing a regulator or a motor or something like that. I think from memory here, I was just searching for a wiring fault. So, yeah, that's the black middle clip. Trying to put it on, it come off again into the door trim, so I had to take it back out of the door trim, put it back on the door. It's a bit of a mongrel, that one. I can't remember any other BMWs having a door trim center plug like that. It was just a mongrel. So once you get it back on, sort of just like any other door trims, just hammer on with your hands the little plugs, little trims on the outsides, and put your screws back in. And that's it for a E60 rear door trim removal. Well, if you have any other questions or comments, leave them in the section below. Thanks for watching. And if you have anything else,